I had several drinks and we were celebrating, and when I went to the restroom, I just noted that my urine was a different color. And that's the first time I realized there was a problem. I didn't talk to anybody about it. Maybe I had too much champagne. I thought it would just go away. After about a couple of weeks, it did not go away. I mean, I felt, well, let me drink more water, let me stop. Not that I drink a lot, but I said, yeah, let me just stop drinking at all. Let me just drink a lot of water and see what happens. But when I was on the plane and I went to the bathroom, I noticed there was blood, this time more blood, like real drops of blood on the toilet seat in the bathroom. And I said to myself, you know, I better do something about it. I better call somebody.
Well, he came here with a problem of having hematuria, and then we found out that he had bladder cancer. It happened by itself, but some risk factor involved, like the patient who heavy smoking, also those who are working in some chemical industry with some chemical ingredient can make the bladder cancer as well.
And so I have a friend who lives here who said, hey, get over here. So I said, okay. So I flew out on a Saturday here and arrived here Sunday night. And he scheduled all of that for me to enter Med Park on Monday morning. I did the standard physical here, which was a few hours in the morning, all sorts of tests that happened. I mean, more tests than anyone can even think of. It would take 3 months in the United States to get the tests done that I had here in 3 hours. All of the x-rays, all of the blood tests, all of the ultrasound, not knowing what the issue or the problem was. No idea. I thought, you know, I had an ulcer or something with a gallstone or whatever. They said, come in and see a doctor that can look at all your tests and let you know if anything is wrong. I had some issues with my skin. I had some issues with my liver. They saw little like spots on the liver, and they saw a little stone in my bladder. So after I had all of that done, normally you go out and you wait weeks and months, and I'm thinking, God, I can't stick around here for a month and get all of these. What am I gonna do? When am I gonna see them? They said, no, you're gonna see them all today. I did the dermatology, I did the liver stuff, and then came to Dr. Paiboon. And he sits down in his computer, and I'm sitting here, and he says, I see you have a spot in your bladder. Dr. Paiboon is a very intuitive man, not a man of many words, but a very genius of a thoughtful, gentle, kind manner of a person. I instantly felt comfortable with him because he took all the data, delivered the news, and was short and to the point.
John, he came here quite early. The cancer that we found from the cystoscopy, which is the endoscope, the size of the cancer is quite large, about 2 to 3 centimeters. We call the tumor at the dome of the bladder, which is the area of difficulty for endoscope operation.
He says, we have to operate. We have to go into your bladder, have full surgery, and remove it. This was on a Saturday. You know, to get a team together for a major surgery like that is a lot of people. You know, people don't realize you got to get anesthesiologists and all of their people. You got to get oxygen. You got to get a whole operating room together and moving pieces. It takes time to build a team like that. You're talking 14, 15 people you got to get together. So I'm thinking, when is this going to be? This was a Saturday. He says, we're going to start this Monday morning. So on Monday morning, I went in for a highly successful surgery to remove the early stages of a cancer diagnosis, of bladder cancer.
Normally, this kind of cancer at this site of the bladder will need an open operation and remove part of bladder at the dome and then repair the bladder, which is one of the major operations. Fortunately, we have the technology of the laser, which normally we use this laser for prostate surgery that called the PVP Greenlight, can be used in the bladder cancer as well. And with this laser is able us to do the surgery by endoscope.
That was removed on a Monday, you know, in a week, gone. And this is something that it spreads very rapidly, you know. And if you don't catch it and you wait and it goes through the bladder wall, you're in deep trouble.
Yeah, he's very lucky. We can remove the whole cancer without making the bladder perforation and can remove the total tumor.
That was on the Monday, and then after they operated, I was here for 2 days recovering in these rooms that I stayed at after the surgery.
The good thing for doing endoscope surgery with laser is the patient can have very quick and early recovery. He doesn't need to stay in the hospital for many days and can return to normal life as soon as he left the hospital without the need for recovery time for major surgery. Furthermore, this is better than the former endoscope surgery that we use the electric cautery. The patient will have much less pain and almost no pain at all. Like John, he said that he got no pain at all since after operation and no bleeding problem, only need catheterization. The catheter needs to remain for only one night. This is one of the major advantages for this technology.
You know, Dr. Paiboon, the highly trained specialist using state-of-the-art lasers to go in and cut out cells from the small wall is such a delicate procedure that it's just hard to believe, you know, talking to people. Well, they had that here. And so the recovery time was much less than a lot of places in the US that don't have this state-of-the-art equipment.
Bladder cancer, once it happened at any point, can happen at other area in the bladder.
He needed some time to see if the immunotherapy was working.
Other part of the bladder is in the same environment, so have the same risk for developing bladder cancer again. We check them every 3 months for at least 2 years, and then after that, we are spreading the time for follow-up to 4 months, 6 months, or yearly later.
Time, that's important, you know? Time for healing, time for your work, time for your family, time personally, right? So Dr. Paiboon here was able to catch it early. And that's what this facility did. It caught it early because of the tests and the way they test and do things here is different than in the United States, you know? So I felt, this guy knows what he's doing, I'm gonna go with this treatment.
Bladder cancer is the cancer that can be cured if we find early. Any patient that has warning sign like blood in the urine, or we call hematuria, come to see the doctor and evaluate whether he has the bladder cancer or not.
If you see any blood in your urine, you need to immediately go to your doctor and get it checked out. Hopefully it could be something else other than bladder cancer, but if you see it, treat it like it is and ask for those tests immediately instead of waiting and just getting a pill and, you know, they don't know what it is.
Anyway, nowadays we have more special urine tests that can check for the possibility of having better cancer before doing cystoscopy.
That if you truly care about your health and your life, you need to get over here and go to Med Park and have your stuff checked out, because it saved my life. I mean, Med Park saved my life.
Med Park Hospital, redefining healthcare.